So, greetings again from Spreadsheet Central. I'm going to walk you through step four, which is the cumulative interest payment here, because I saw some folks posting in Campus Wire and they weren't quite doing it right. So I want to give you guys some directions on how to finish this up. So I'm going to share my screen. And pop open the starter file. So down here in row 15, we want the interest expense. So how much interest did we pay in year one of the loan, two, year three, year four? So here's the interest. Here's the loan information over here. So let's get going on it. So equals cumulative interest payment. Now the rate is this 4.5%. That's the annual rate though. So we need to divide that by the number of periods per year, which is at 12. So that's that. The number of periods in the loan, NPER, is this 4 years times that 12. So there's 48 payments over the length of the year. The present value of the loan is that $64,000. Now the start period for the first year is going to be just the number one, and the end period is the number 12. And I see a lot of students doing that and posting that in Campus Wire, and that's okay as a starting point, but you need to be able to copy this formula across without having to change it a bunch of times. So while you can do that just as a placeholder to see if you get the right number, that's okay. And I'm going to do it here in a minute, but for full credit, you can't leave it like this. And also on the exam, you'll have to do this formula correctly as well. So better to learn it now. And then finally, zero for the end of the payment period type. Let's see. Close the parentheses. That works. Now I want to be able to drag it across, but I know it's going to explode on me. Hopefully you know why too. But mainly it's because all the referencing is incorrect. So since I'm just going to be dragging the formula across, all I need to do is put the dollar signs in front of the column. Don't absolutely reference that because we don't need dollar signs in front of the rows. And if you do that, you're not going to get the full points. But you guys know all about that by now. So I'm putting dollar signs in front of all the J's and hit enter. And now as I drag it across, at least I get four numbers. Now, if I were to want to do this manually, I could come in here and put year two, that's going to be 13 to 24. So let's just down here, let's put in some numbers here. So the start period, let me just say this is the start period. And this is the end period. So I want 1 and 12, and then over here I want 13 and 24. And then if I highlight those, just because I'm wanting another keyboard shortcut, I can drag it across, highlight those two, notice the pattern, drag it across. And now I have the starting and ending period for each of the 4 years. So now up here in this formula, rather than the hard coding the 1 and 12, I want to have a formula that creates those 1 and the 12s based on the year number. So if I can think about this, 1 turns into 1 for the start period and 12 for the end period. 2 turns into 13 and 24. 3 should have 25 and 36. So I should be able to calculate based on the year number these two numbers. So let's do the easy one first. 1 times the number of periods in the year is the end period. So I'm just going to replace this equals the year times that cell. And I'm going to put a dollar sign in front of the J so I can drag this formula across. Just drag that across. Now I have a formula that does the end of the year, the end period for me. So I'm going to take that and I'm going to highlight everything but the equal sign, hit copy on my keyboard, hit the escape key, that's the key here, and then go up into this formula and double click on the 12 and paste it. So that's a good sign. We got that. And if I want to, I can drag it across just to make sure that it works. And at least I have the right formula. Now that one is hard coded in there, so that's still causing me problems, but I can get some do some math to do that as well. So let's now come up with the formula here. Now this is a little trickier because, you know, how do I get one to turn into a one? How do I get two to turn into a 13? How do I get three to turn into a 25? Well, I notice one way of doing it is the start period is always 11 less than the end period. So I can go about it and do it that way. So let's do that as a starting point. So I just need to say this cell equals, again, it's that one times the cell here. Hit F4 a couple times to put my dollar sign in front of the J. And then I can just subtract 11 from it. Now if I take that and highlight those, and another way of filling to the right is using the Control R key. So Control R. And now I have a formula in there. And that's a lot better, and that'll get you full credit on the assignment. But you can notice here I'm hard coding the 11 in here. Now that 11 will always work if there's 12 periods per year, but what happens if there's 4 periods a year? And subtracting 11 from them wouldn't work. You'd want to subtract 3 from them at that point. So rather than hard coding that 11, you can get a little fancy in here and put in parentheses, hey, just take this number, whatever it is, and hit F4 a couple times to get the dollar sign in front of the J and subtract 1 from it. And that will give us 11, but it'll also now work for whatever number happens to be jammed into J6. So I can take that and copy it across, and now I'm good. And now, since I know my formula works, I can take that formula, copy it, hit the escape key, come in here, double click on that hard-coded one to get it out of there and paste in its place and hit enter. And now I can highlight those keys, those cells, and hit the Control R and I'm done. And I have the right numbers confirmed for this semester. So Merry Christmas to you or Happy Valentine's Day, but I'm a couple weeks late, but hey, at least we're trying here. So that's it for this helper video. Thank you very much, and go Noles.